Dear students, let us continue the module 1. This is going to be lecture video 9. In this one, again we will continue with the 4 IoT functional aspect of the simplified IoT architecture. In this one, we will be discussing about the layer 2, which is the communication network layer. So, based on the ranges of the sensors or objects, how far it can be detected with the receiver, the different networks are categorized. Like range estimates are grouped by category names that illustrate the environment or the vertical where data collection over that range is expected. Common groups are as follows. So, based on different ranges, of the objects and receivers, different networks are categorized. Here are the groups. So, one is first is called PAN, that is the personal area network. So, scale of a few meters. This is the personal space around a person. A common wireless technology for this scale is Bluetooth. So it works within the personal area network. It works within a few meters, like Bluetooth. It has some ranges around the objects where it can be detected by the receiver. Next network is HAN, home area network. So the scale of a few tens of meters. So, its range of receiver is around a few tens of meters. At this scale, common wireless technologies for IoT include Zigbee and Bluetooth low energy. So, these are the devices can work for the home area networks. A few tens of meters, like 10 meters, 20 meters and all those things. Then, another thing is NAN. Neighborhood area network. So scale of few hundred of meters. So the receiver of this object can be few hundreds of meters. Like if the object is around 100 meters or 200 meters, then it can be detected. Then by the it can be detected by the receiver. So such kind of objects is called neighborhood area network. Then FAN, field area network, in scale of several tens of meters to several hundreds of meters. So it comes under, suppose, the 20 meters to 200 meters, 30 meters to 300 meters or 400 meters. If the object is present in this range and it can be detected, then it comes under the field area network. Then LAN, local area network, as everyone knows, because we all have studied in the computer network 1, what is local area network. So its range is up to the 100 meters, 200 meters or 300 meters till where you can put the LAN within a building or something like that. So this term is very common in networking and it is therefore also commonly used in the IoT space when standard network field technologies like Ethernet or IEEE 802.11, it is called the local area network. So its range is up to the 100 meters, 200 meters and all that. So this is how the different communication networks are divided. So similar, another thing is similar ranges also do not mean similar topologies. So so two networks which are present at the same distance, but they can also have a different topologies. So if they differ in terms of topology, then also they will be considered as a different network. So some technologies offer flexible connectivity structure to extend communication possibilities. different topologies. In this sense, we can see that this is a star topology, then this is a cluster star topology, then another we can have a mesh topology. So different topologies have different simple way of communication or complex way of communication. Next one is layer 3, which is called the application and analytics layer. So once connected to a network, our smart objects exchange information with other systems, as we know that. Once the connection network is done, then smart object can share or exchange the information with other systems. As soon as our IoT network expands more than a few sensors, the power of Internet of Things appears in the applications that make use of them. Next one is analytics application. So this type of application collects data from multiple smart objects, processes the collected data and displays information resulting from the data that was processed. So such kind of analytics application, we should analyze the data. Suppose a huge amount of data it is collected from multiple smart objects sensors. And so all the huge data is not benefited for our business fund, only few data. So we should put those data into some format, some graphical format, some diagrammatical format or bar diagram or pie chart, and we should extract the information from it. So that is the analysis of the data need to be done in the this layer. That's all about all the three layers of the core IoT functional stack we studied. Thank you very much.